In this segment, we'll talk about how to find length of a path, and we'll do this through an example. And so here what we are seeing is a second order polynomial, and we want to be able to find the length of this function from 2 to 8. We already know that the length of a path is given by this general formula here. So what we need to do is to just plug in the function as well as the lower and upper limits here. So we already know that a is equal to 2, b is 8, and the first derivative would be equal to the derivative of the second order polynomial. And that turns out to be 2. So all the things available to us. So let's go and see. So our length is equal to this particular expression here. This is from the previous slide. So we can make some change of variable so that it looks like an integral of which we know the exact value. So for example, what we can do is we can say let u equal to 13.25 minus 2.75x, which is this quantity right here. So what that allows us to do is then du is minus 2.75 dx. And when x is equal to 2, which is this number right here, u becomes this number here. And when x is equal to 8, which is the upper limit, u becomes negative 8.75. So because of these numbers now, what we can do is we can rewrite our length of the path to be going from 7.75 to minus 8.75 because those are the new limits based on the value of u now, and square root of 1 plus u square. And for dx from here, we can substitute du divided by minus 2.75. So now we can see that this particular integral, we can look at a table and find out what the exact value of this integral is. So let's go and see what that is. If you have an integral which is 1 plus square root of 1 plus u square du, that is given by this integral. And there are quite a number of good YouTube videos available to you to find out how this exact integration is done for this particular integral. I can show it to you, but then the video itself will become lengthy. So so this is the solution to an integral like this one. So based on what we have length is equal to going from 7.75 to minus 8.75. This is what we have from the previous slide. So now this will give us 1/2 this quantity. So I'm taking this quantity here, taking it outside. So I get minus 1 divided by 2.75. And so this value here at minus 8.75 is minus 38.53. This quantity at minus 8.75 is minus 1.433 just by substituting. And then of course we'll subtract whatever we get at the lower limit, which is 7.75. So this quantity at 7.75 is 30.28. And this quantity here at 7.75 is 1.327. So taking all these terms and calculating, we get 26.03. And that is the end of this segment, which gives you the exact value of the length of the curve.